Another calendar app, another day. Today we're reviewing a brand new calendar app called Mayday. And it seems like calendar apps are just everywhere at the moment, just floating around waiting for us to check them out. But Mayday wants to be very much AI focused, manage and learn from you as you go, and manage your tasks as well. Let's take a deep dive into this application, see whether it's for you and whether it is worth checking out in the future. So welcome here, my name's Francesco. If you're on the hunt for any calendar apps or any productivity tools, jump over to Toolfinder, the best place to find it, and we've curated all the best lists and reviews right there. Honestly, you'll find a productivity app that suits you, whether it's a calendar app like Mayday or many of the others. So it's strange because this calendar app is actually been something I haven't checked out. I've had the beta for a while, just haven't been able to commit to checking it out fully, but they launched today. And they launch on, I believe, iOS and Mac, although I'll include the details below because I believe that it's still pending in terms of the actual release. But the calendar app wants to help you manage your calendar using AI, and it does that by learning from you. And I'll show you some of the core features. I've actually played around with this for a little bit prior to this video so that we can make sure we skip to the gems of the feature. And the first thing is, if you see in this top left-hand corner, you can see Mayday is still learning about me, and it's 41% complete. But what it's doing is it's analyzing the calendar, everything from scheduled events to event editing, synced calendar, and use of smart tags. So what it's trying to do is get together how I use a calendar and make decisions based on that. So that's really interesting. I'm gonna let it run in the background. Obviously this demo will be with 41% completed. So imagine it even further increased and the knowledge even better. So in its essence, this calendar application wants to be a way for you to manage your calendar more effectively. And it does that through something called protecting or calendar shielding your time. So for example, one thing you can do in the settings, here we go, is go to calendar shield. And basically you can set this on or off, it's an optional feature. But basically from here you can see what calendars are protected and the meeting threshold that you might want, which is really interesting. And I actually called this one of the best demonstrations of the way that you're managing your schedule between meetings. So if you want to have less meetings like I do and more tasks, you can have it set. And once this is set, it means that your time on tasks will be prioritized over your time in meetings. So this is a really nice ideal functionality. You can also set up focus time as well so that it automatically creates a custom push when you are busy on your calendar so that people can see in the event details, don't bother me sort of thing, I'm focusing. And you can set it to automatically protect your time, which is really interesting. So how does that actually work in practice? Well, the one thing you can do is you can do it per day. So for example, if you're going a really busy day, like 1.5 hours of meetings, that's a busy day for me, guys. Then you can go ahead and individually protect that day, meaning that all of the time gets blocked out and anyone that actually activates that time will just completely get prompted that you are busy, which is quite good. And this appears in the case, so you can see here that it's starting to sort of take that out of the time, which is really good. And what it also does is it reflects that in the reusable links, which allow you to schedule them. So let's just show you this and show you what the scheduling page looks like. So for example, if I wanted to book somebody to book a hour with me, as you can see on that Thursday, no times become available. So you can start to see how it operates both externally and internally. So you can also see that this scheduling assistant allows you to book times with me. But what's the most interesting about it is they've got these like green ones. And these are AI suggested times ideal for me, apparently. Obviously, this is not fully learned on me. It's 41% learned on me, but you can imagine it gets more accurate as it starts to learn how you utilize a calendar. But this reminds me of a feature that the Sainsbury's app have. And for those who are watching that don't have Sainsbury's in their country, it's a shopping store, a bit like Walmart, a bit like them. And you can see like the ideal slot for the driver to arrive based on the most or least amount of fuel. And I really like this feature because it's like, Okay. 1 p.m. is a feature that a time that this is not going to pee off this person, or it's going to make this person more happy. So I really like this feature in terms of a very unique approach to schedule management. So that's scheduling abilities. You can use single use ones, or you can create reusable ones, and they can be optimized and set up with the tag function. So you can set up the tags to be really specific about, you know, for example, what is your typical day and what does it look like? And you can see a typical day and set it up. Like, for example, you can have it so that meetings are always on Thursday afternoons. That's something that I do. So you can set aside time to manually put that in. So you can start to see that you can create really functional time and sleep and wake times to really enhance all the basis for planning ahead. And you can see this is a smart tag functionality here, which means you can set up smart tags to basically align with the type of calendars you use. So for example, in this one, you can see that these are holidays, but I can put in like UK holidays, and it makes sure to sort of understand that, if that makes sense. And you can set up things here as a personal, and I can set this up instead of being external, I could create work. So you're starting to see that what it's trying to do is, once you really optimize the settings, it starts to filter down into the application. Now, the other element is task management, and you can go ahead, and if I skip to today view, I can add a task for today. So in this case, it could be 45 minutes. So it does auto rescheduling of your tasks. So in this case, I might say review Mayday. I've already had that task on my list, but it's 45 minutes long. And what it does is it instantly works out, okay, this is a good time in my calendar. Obviously, it's still learning about me, 47% now, but what it's trying to do is go off of the information that you've populated based on your scheduling hours. Here in this case, it's flexible. So I might, because I'm past Tuesday at that time, what I might do is just remove that window and hypothetically put it here so that tasks are much more preferenced to be there. Now I'm going to add another task to see whether it recalibrates it. And as you can see, it's already instantly worked out that I like that time, and it is going to set that up. And you can also set up elements like importance. This also plays into the factor when it comes to the importance of a task and actually scheduling it into the right places, and importance over other ones. And you can also set up advanced functions like syncing the event to certain things or rescheduling it for, say, this week, which means that you can see that this item gets moved. And if I go to next week, I have not found it yet, but I'm sure it's here. So if I go and press this one, this week, not next week. So you can start to see that Wednesdays at 2 p.m., it looks like a good time to me to focus on the task. So what this application is trying to do is a combination of smarter calendar management combined with smarter task management. And the more you use it, the more that the Mayday AI will get more accurate. And I actually had the opportunity yesterday, as you can see on the events, to chat with the team a little bit more and to understand what their vision is with this. And it looks like they're really trying to help make it more of an AI assistant to your day to make it more accurate. But they also wanted to state that they are planning to make, during the public beta, everything free, but actually the plans with the, in terms of the release of the AI-based functionality when they go fully public, will likely be a paid product, which is typical with all of these products, and there's sort of like a premium wall behind it. But as a whole, this application is a very interesting one. The elements that I particularly like about it were the advanced setting abilities to set up your perfect day and the calendar shield function. That's probably the most advanced I've seen settings apart from Reclaim, which is another calendar app, much more designed for teams. And the other elements that I like about it is the scheduling link, which was really nice, and the smart tags, which seem really cool in being able to automatically set up. And as I said, I guess I purposely did that we've only got 50% of the learning data based on my calendar, but at the same time, it gets smarter more every time you use it, and it will completely grow each time you use it and manage your calendar. So it's a very interesting approach to calendar management with tasks in there. A lot of these calendar apps are doing this at the moment, trying to get tasks and calendar in one base. But I rate Mayday, and I think it's got an interesting future, and it's really well built. Just thinking of other elements, I'll include other elements in our full in-depth review on Toolfinder, because it'll have all the stuff like availability, pricing, and more that you need to know when making a decision to see if this is your next calendar app. But folks, I hope you enjoyed this feature, and I hope it gave you everything you need to know. Just to be clear, you can jump over to Toolfinder and find any productivity tool there if you're in the hunt for them. But a big thank you for stopping by. Make sure you hit thumbs up, subscribe, and I will see you folks in the future. Cheerio, and maybe I will review another calendar app next time. Let's see. So many. Cheers, folks, and I'll see you soon.